It's Food Plot Week, and today we're at my farm in the Ozark Mountains talking about year-round food plots. I've said this before, but we'll say it again. Never be completely, fully committed to one system in your food plot strategy. Always be willing to accept a curveball and roll with it. And this food plot is in the middle of a large tract of timber. We dozed this out probably 4 to 5 years ago, and we planted soybeans the first year, knowing that the deer were gonna put too much pressure on it and we wouldn't have standing grains. And we converted to clover for 3 years. So this was perennial clover with alfalfa, chicory, a couple different types of clover, and it did really well. But over the years, because we can't get a fertilizer buggy back here yet, we've got to fix the roads, it has gradually gotten weedier and weedier and more problems arise. We actually dozed out some additional acres, made it up to 3.5 acres. And so then it called for, let's convert it back, let's go to a Roundup Ready crop, which is soybeans and corn, and let's see what happens. Well, now that it's large enough, you can see the deer have browsed this down a good amount. There's not a soybean that's not been browsed, and the corn has done incredibly well. Now, this is unfertilized hybrid. It's a dwarf corn that has not had a speck of fertilizer other than following up 3 years of a legume. And to be honest with you, for the Ozark Mountains, I'm pretty proud of it. The guys in crop country are gonna watch this and just laugh and go ahead and laugh it up. But this is a unfertilized corn in the Ozark Mountains on a ridgetop, and it's done pretty well. A couple of these are multiple eared, but we have good corn, which is gonna feed our deer and probably our bears and our raccoons through the fall, hopefully into the winter. There's enough acreage of it that I hope it withstands the winter. We're gonna have standing grain with soybeans. Even though they're shorter, they'll still have pods. So they'll be feeding the deer corn and soybeans, carbohydrates in the winter. We have enough, because of the browse pressure, enough sunlight. So we have brassicas coming through, and then we're also gonna plant cereal grains. So we're gonna have crops all the way through the winter. Now this next February, we'll likely revert back and frost seed clovers into this. So we're gonna go a full growing season and a big portion of the fall without a legume-based food plot system to try to get everything, all the weeds under control. Then we're gonna revert back to clover, perennial clover, next year. And this will just be an incredible system that we've used just to try to change things up and always be providing great forage, as well as controlling our weeds and always changing our system from lagoon base to grass base to broadleaf base to where we're mining the nutrients and continuing to have healthy food plots, and therefore we have successful hunts out of this field.